Now let's take a look at how circuit switching works. An important thing about VPI and VCI indicators is that they are only valid between switches. This means they change all the time as you travel across the network. This isn't so strange if you compare it to a cross-country trip in a car. As you go across the country, you travel on different highways. Similarly, as an ATM packet goes across the network, it uses different circuit identifiers. So, from the computer to the first switch, I use connection 3134. The first number is the VPI, and the second number is the VCI. So, 3134 means virtual path 31 and virtual channel 34. Then, from switch to switch, I use 77291, and then, finally, I use 126453 to reach the final destination. The VPI-VCI values have no value beyond just identifying the route. VPI-VCI values are also randomly selected. The switch just selects which values are available when it needs them and uses them. Each switch is configured during the connection setup phase about what to do with the traffic. It's instructed that if a packet comes in with a specific VPI-VCI, it should go out with another specific value. Once again, this is like a driving trip. Take I-95 from Philadelphia to New York, then take I-80 from New York to Chicago, then on until you reach the end of your trip.